Hello friends, in today's video we will be learning two ways to create bouncing balls animation effects in PowerPoint presentations. Hello once again friends, in today's video we would be discussing two cool animation tricks and effects. Friends, one important thing to remember is that the basic fundamentals are the same for different versions of PowerPoint, be it 2007, 2010, 2013 or 2016, etc., both for Windows as well as for Mac. And with each new version, there are new and better features for the user's benefit. So let us see some examples which we are going to learn today. Friends, this is the first example of the beautiful bouncing balls animation which we are going to learn. Let us see the second example. Friends, this is another method of creating bouncing balls animation effects in PowerPoint. So let us proceed ahead and start learning. Let us first of all discuss the first method of creating such beautiful animations. So friends, here we are in the first method. Let us first of all have a preview of this one in order to have a better understanding. So you can see these are three balls and I've also inserted a smiling face just to have a good visual effect, and they are all bouncing beautifully in the PowerPoint slide. Now, in order to create the slide, let me come over to the Home tab and insert a new blank slide. And then the first thing which I need to do is that I need to insert a picture. So I already have a picture of a few balls and a smiling face. So for starting, let me insert the picture of this particular ball. Now, after the ball has been inserted, let me just reduce the size in order to suit my requirements, like this. And then let me bring the ball here. Now, the first step which I need to do is that I need to come over here to the Animations tab, and then I need to select a particular type of animation, that is the fly-in animation. The default direction is from the bottom towards the top. Now I need to change this default direction. So I need to come over here to the effects options and make the direction from top. Now, after setting the direction from top towards bottom, I need to come over here and starting, it should be with previous. Duration of 1 second is okay. And then let me come over to the effects options and I need to select this particular option, that is a smooth start. Now let me preview this and you can see this particular animation in effect. Now the second step is that I need to again select this ball and add a particular animation of a path animation. Now I need to have a line animation which starts from the center of this ball up till all the way, let us say up till here. And then I need to come over here. For starting, it should be with previous. The duration of this has to be 1 second. And then I need to come over here to the effects options. And then I need to make sure that it should have only a smooth end. And then I need to click this option also, that is auto reverse. This I am clicking because the first animation of the ball, it comes down like this. And the second animation is that the ball goes from bottom towards the top. And then it has to come down also. So that is why I am clicking the auto reverse option. And as far as the timing is concerned, since the second animation starts when the first animation ends, so I've already selected it that it should start with previous, and the delay option should be 1 second in this case, because 1 second is the time duration of the first animation. So let me now preview this animation up till this stage. So you can see here, we are halfway through. Now, the next step is that I need to again select this ball and again I need to have an animation of a line animation which should again be starting from the center of this ball, and I can bring it probably up till this point. Now, again I need to come over here. For starting, it has to start with previous. Duration, it has to be 1 second. For the effect options, I need it to have a smooth end only and then auto reverse, because as we saw in the previous animation, This ball needs to go up and then it needs to come down to have a cool bouncing effect. And then as far as the timing is concerned, for this particular step, the delay should be 1 second plus the duration of the second animation. Now, the duration of the second animation is 1 second to go up and 1 second to come down because we had selected the auto reverse. And 1 second was the duration of the first step. So 1 plus 2 seconds is 3 seconds, and the delay for the third step should be 3 seconds. Friends, this animation is very easy once you start practicing it yourself. And then I can assure you that you would be an expert in no time. Now, let me see the preview up till this stage. So ball comes down, it goes up, then again it goes up and it comes down. So we need to add one final step of this animation in order to complete this. So for that, I need to again select this ball, and again I need to add a line animation, and again I need to start from the center like this, and I need to bring this ball somewhere here. This is the last bounce of the ball which we are trying to show. And now let me come over here. Starting, it has to be with previous. For this last bounce, I need the duration to be 0.5 seconds. And then coming over to the effects options, I need a smooth end and an auto reverse. And then as far as the delay is concerned, I need to make this delay as 5 seconds. Now friends, in order to create this kind of an animation, we have added 4 steps. In the first step, we added an animation which was fly in. In the second step, the ball started from the bottom and it moved towards the top and then it came back. Similarly, for the third as well as the fourth animations, the ball moved up and came down and then it moved up again to a shorter distance and then it came down again. So let us now preview this animation. So it goes up, then again up, but to a shorter distance, then again up to another smaller shorter distance, and then it comes down. Now let us play this animation in the slideshow from the current slide like this, and you can see here that we have been able to create a beautiful bouncing ball animation effect. So now let me press the escape button and come back. So friends, we are back. Now in order to create an animation effect like we saw in the beginning, I just need to insert different elements. I have inserted 3 balls, and just for the sake of making it a visually more beautiful animation, I have inserted this particular smiling face also. So let me come back to my main slide, and now let me insert the various pictures. Let me insert all of these pictures of the balls as well as the smiling face like this. Then let me just reduce the size of all of these pictures to suit my requirements. And then let me rearrange these pictures as we saw in this particular slide. So the face is at the second number, the colored ball is at the third number. Let me rearrange all of these pictures according to this. So let me bring the face here. Let me reduce the size of the face a little bit. Then let me increase the size of this colored ball as well as increase the size of this particular ball like this. Okay, now the next step is that I need to bring all of these pictures towards the same level at the bottom side like this, and then I need to add animations for these various balls which is similar to the animation which I applied for this first ball. Now friends, this method is very easy. I don't have to go through the entire process of adding different steps for all of these pictures again and again. What I can do very easily is that I select this particular picture, I come over to the animations tab, and you can see here this is a particular button where it is written animation painter. This is a very beautiful thing in PowerPoint that if I select this particular animation painter, then it copies the entire animation which was applied to this particular selected picture. And then when I select this picture, then the same kind of animation effect gets applied to this picture also. And similarly, I can just select this one once again, come to the animations painter, and then click on this picture. And then again, I need to select here, come over to the animations painter, and select this picture. So friends, I have been able to add animation effects to all of the elements in this slide. Now, first of all, let us see a preview of this particular animation like this. You can see here all these balls or the smiling face, they are bouncing, but they are very symmetrical. That is, all of them are following almost the same path, and this is not creating a very beautiful animation. So what I need to do is, I just need to concentrate on these small arrow points for each of these animation effects, and I need to change them so that these are not symmetrical, these are all different from each other. This will have a positive effect, that is, when I play this animation once again, then all of these balls will be bouncing at different heights, and thus it is going to give me a beautiful effect. So let me first of all start off with a smiling face. Now let me choose this particular arrow and then bring it a little bit down like this, and then let me change the position of this arrow also. Let me bring it down here, and then let me choose this position and bring it down a little bit like this. So my major purpose is that this animation should be a little bit different from this animation. Now let me change the animation effect for this one. Let me move this arrow a little bit up like this, and then let me move this arrow also a little bit up, and then let me bring this arrow a little bit down. Friends, let me just reduce the size of the slide for better understanding. And now this is the last element. I need to change this line for this element also. This is quite a big ball in comparison to the other balls, so the bounce height should be a little bit higher like this. And for this particular point, let me move it here. The third point, let me move it here, and that should do the job. Now let me have a preview of this animation first of all. Now you can see all these balls are bouncing, but they are bouncing at different heights. So this creates a much more visually appealing effect to this animation. Now let me just increase the size of this ball for a little bit more better effect like this. Let me increase the size of this ball and increase the size of this ball also a little bit. Now let me first of all save this presentation. And now for the purpose of seeing this presentation in the slideshow, let me first of all come here to the very first picture, and then I need to start it on click, so that when I play the slideshow, then I need to press the enter button in order to start the slide. So let me now start the slideshow from the current slide. And now let me press the enter button. So friends, as you can see here, we have been able to create a beautiful bouncing balls animation effects in PowerPoint. So let me now press the escape button and come back. So friends, we are back in the slide. Now, one last effect which we can add in this slide is that I need to have a sort of a platform on which all of these balls are bouncing, so that it becomes more beautiful. So for that, I need to come over here to the shapes menu, and I need to insert a line which is extending from one side of the slide to the other side like this. And then I can do some formatting for this line. You can see here, this is the formatting tab which is opened up. I need this to be a solid line, and then I can make the color of this line to be a dark color like this, and then I can increase the width of this line to, let us say, 8 points. This should be good. And then let me just right click on this line and then send it towards back. Now let me again save this presentation, and then let me start the slideshow from the current slide. And now let me press the enter button. So friends, as you can see, we have created a nice platform so that these balls can easily bounce upon it. So let me now press the escape button and come back. So friends, this was the first method of how we can create beautiful bouncing balls animation in PowerPoint. Let us now see the second method. In this method, we are going to learn how to create a bouncing ball effect from one side towards another. Let us see this method in more detail now, and let me just reduce the size for better understanding. So you can see here, there are two balls here. One ball is going to bounce from left towards right, and the second ball is going to bounce from right towards left. So let me first of all preview this. So this is the first ball and this is the second ball. So let us learn how to make this. For that I need to insert a new blank slide. Let me just increase the size now. Now I need to insert a picture of a ball as we had done before. So let me insert this particular picture like this, and then let me reduce the size of this picture somewhat like this, and then let me bring this ball here. Now in order to create this sort of a bouncing effect, I need to add a particular type of animation, that is a path animation. It is a custom path animation of a bounce animation. So you can see here the ball is bouncing like this. This is a very short motion path, so I can just drag this particular animation up till this particular point, and then it becomes a more smooth animation. Now let us come over here. The starting of this animation should be on click. It is okay. The duration of this animation should be 2 seconds. That is also okay. Now let us come over to the effects options. For the effect options, I don't need a smooth start, but yes, I do need a smooth end. This will become evident when we play the animation. So let us preview this particular animation now. And you can see the ball has started bouncing from right towards left, but you can see the effect is coming very simple. It is not very beautiful effect. So in order to make it more beautiful, we can add a spin to this ball so that when it is bouncing, it is also spinning. Now, in order to add a spinning effect, I again need to select this ball, come over here to the emphasis effects, and then add a spinning effect to this ball. And this should be starting with previous, because we want the spin to be happening at the same time when the ball is bouncing. Then duration. The bounce duration was 2 seconds, so let us keep the spin duration as 1.5 seconds. And as far as the effect options is concerned, I don't need a smooth start, I don't need a smooth end. And now let me preview this particular animation. So you can see here the ball is coming, but the spin direction is not what I need. This ball is moving from right towards left, so the spin direction should be anti-clockwise. So I come over here to the effects options, and you can see here the property, it is 360 degrees clockwise, which I need to make counterclockwise. So now let me play this animation, and you can see here now we have been able to create a beautiful bouncing ball animation along with a spinning ball animation. Now in a similar way, let me insert another ball. Let me insert a picture of this ball here like this, and then let me reduce the size of this ball, and for the sake of symmetry, let me keep the size of both of these balls to be the same. So now let me bring this ball here towards the other side, and then let me leave it here. Now I need to add a bounce animation here, so let me click it, come to the animations tab, and select a particular path animation, which is a custom motion path of a bounce effect. Let me just reduce the size of the slide further for better understanding. So you can see here the default bounce effect is from right towards left. This I need to change from left towards right. So I need to select this particular effect option, come over here to the effect options tab, and choose the bounce animation towards right. So you can see here now this ball is bouncing towards the right, but as we saw in this first example, this bounce is very small, so I need to again select it and then drag it towards a particular this portion of the slide like this. Now let me make some modifications in the animations for this ball. So I need to come over here. Starting is on click, that is okay. Duration is 2 seconds, that is also okay. As far as the effects option is concerned, I don't need a smooth start, but I need a smooth end, so I keep it as it is. Now first of all, let us preview this animation. So this is the first ball coming in, and this is the second ball coming in. Now as a last step, I just need to add a spin effect to this particular ball. So I again need to click this, and I need to add an emphasis effect of spin to this particular ball. And then let me do some modifications in the animation for this ball. The spinning effect should be starting with previous, and let me keep the duration of the spin as 1.5 seconds. And as far as the effects option is concerned, I don't need a smooth start, I don't need a smooth end for the spin. And now let me just save this presentation and then let me play the slideshow from the current slide. And now let me press enter button. So this is the first ball coming in and this is the second ball coming in. So let me come back. So we are back. Let me just increase the size of the slide for better understanding. And now as a last step, I can just add a sort of a platform on which both of these balls are bouncing. So for that, let me insert a rectangular shape like this. And this rectangular shape should be covering the entire length of the slide, something like this. And then let me format this. So let me do right click and come over here to the format shape options. So first of all, I need to fill in some sort of a color or a texture or a picture or a pattern here. So I come over here to the picture or texture fill, and this is already pre-selected. So I come over here to the texture button and then I click here and I can select any of these textures to suit my requirements. I can choose this one, or I can choose this one, or any one of the textures given here. Now, as far as the outline is concerned, I don't need any outline for this particular shape. So I select here no outline, and then I just do right click and send this to back. And then just let me increase the height of this particular rectangle like this. And then let me have a preview of this animation. So you can see here, it is creating a beautiful effect. Let us see this in the slideshow. And I play it from the current slide and then I press enter. So you can see here, friends, once again, we have been able to create a beautiful bouncing balls animation effect in PowerPoint. So let me press the escape button and come back. So friends, we are back in the PowerPoint slide. In today's tutorial, we have been able to learn two ways to create bouncing balls animation effects in PowerPoint. This was the first effect in which the balls were bouncing from top towards bottom. And this was the second effect in which the balls were bouncing from one side towards another. So friends, I hope that you have enjoyed this small video on how to create beautiful bouncing balls animation effects in PowerPoint. In case you have any questions, comments or suggestions, then please mention in the comments below and do subscribe to our channel so that you can have latest updates about all our videos. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video, and I would be uploading a new video soon. Bye for now.
Friends, in order to watch all my latest videos, do subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. And do click this bell icon to get notifications whenever I publish a new video.